It was on this humble cow pasture in 1941 that the city of Santa Barbara put its dreams of air travel on the ground. In keeping with its tradition of inviting citizen input and participation, the city council created the Airport Commission soon thereafter. Nearly 70 years later, the Santa Barbara Airport is the central hub of air travel between Burbank and San Jose.
We have about 825,000 passengers that go through our airport each year. We have over a $12 million operational budget and then a large capital program beyond that.
As an enterprise fund, the airport receives no money from the city's general fund. Revenues come from tenant rents and user fees.
We have about 100 tenants at the airport. They generate about 30 or 35% of our total revenues. And these are commercial industrial tenants. We also have aviation tenants with general aviation or operations related to private aircraft, as well as commercial airline activity at the airport.
The airport leases over 4 million square feet of land and buildings. And that's why the workload of the Airport Commission involves more contract than tarmac.
When I first went on, I had, of course, an aviation background, which frankly wasn't that important. One of the major businesses of running an airport from the city level is rental property. I had some background in that, and it was very helpful. You don't get to tell the guys in the airplanes what to do, but there's a lot to be done on the ground.
The Airport Commission also provides input and advice on capital projects.
One of the things we started in my first go-round was the airport, the runway realignment, I think is the proper term. We effectively moved the runway about 500 feet west, and it was a long drawn out production. Of course, we had to deal with all the powers that be and the Coastal Commission and all that. And right after we got it basically done, an airplane ran off the end into the safety area that we constructed, so we were vindicated right off.
Well, I think one of the most interesting was participating in the new airport terminal design. It will really resolve a lot of the problems that we have in the terminal today with the kind of overcrowding in the waiting rooms. And it's been great to see something that's been really so much needed really moving forward.
This is the time for public comment. Do we have any public comment slips?
The Airport Commission is a conduit for information to travel between staff, city council, and the public.
So, I mean, a couple different aviation groups in the community, and to be able to bring that feedback back to the airport, I think it's really valuable for both sides.
We take information provided to us by our very competent airport administrative staff, look it over, ask questions, and then pass it on to the city council for approval.
The only qualification necessary to be an airport commissioner involves residency. Four members must live in the city of Santa Barbara. Three other members may live in the city or the county. The only requirement is an interest in making sure the airport experience is the best it can be while remaining distinctively Santa Barbara.
We have a very special, unique opportunity to keep a very well-run, efficient airport that can offer a lot of different services and not become just another airport.
Like in all city advisory groups, the name of the game is consensus. And one thing airport commissioners all agree upon is the value of volunteering.
It's an excellent way for people to learn more about what's going on and participate in something that interests them. So it's just a tremendous thing, and we're really fortunate that our city really seeks that community involvement and participation.
Learning about all of the things, be it integrated pest management, be it our hydro mulching on the surrounding areas, flood control, it's been an experience for me and a good one to learn and meet a lot of people who come together and make the team work.
I went in with some preconceived notions, and it was very wrong, and it was much better as it turned out.